That was very appropriately creepy. Hi, Allie. How are you, Allie? What is that, dancing kitten? Oh, that's a Sherry emote. Nice. That's a cute little dancing cat emote. Thank you. I was in the bathroom. I was at the mirror, and I was just like shaving above and below my beard, and I was just looking at it, and I was like, it's just too much beard. Like, it's too much damn beard. I'm being too lazy about it. So I actually, like, got my little trimmer out and, like, reshaped it properly, like, brought it way down, gave myself, like, a proper shaping. And I decided to wear my favorite hat that I wear when I go out. I am a hat person. I am a big hat person. Thank you. I feel like if I start doing more stuff to, like, keep myself, like gussied up and shit like that, maybe it'll kind of help shake the weird, like, depression funk I've been in, and I'll actually, like, go out and do things in the world. That is so good. Oh my god. What's up, Ivan? That is so... Oh my god, that's so good. Oh. It's so good. So Ivan knows about this, and I mentioned it in your chat earlier. I've been lately on my weekends been drinking super cheap whiskey because I have been super broke. Like, I'm talking, like, $10.99 a pint. A liter. $10.99 a liter. Like, $10.99 a liter shit. Like, one step up from, like, bathtub whiskey. Like, horrible, awful, cheap shit. And, every time I talk to my mom about it, she feels really... Because me and my mom hang out on Saturdays, and we've been watching Only Murders in the Building on Hulu. We usually, like, Saturday is, like, I hang out with my mom. Me and my mom have, like, Saturday hangout time. And we usually find, like, stand-up specials to watch or, like, concert VODs to watch. But we really have gotten into that Only Murders in the Building on Hulu lately. And she has, like, her Moscato that she drinks. She gets, like, the good, like, Stella Rosa Moscato. And, I've been drinking, like, this fucking two-buck chuck, and she always feels so bad that I'm having to have this cheap shit. So she threw me a 20 today and was like, when you make your liquor store run, get whatever you want. And I was like, I'm gonna splurge and get Jim Beam. Jim Beam is, like, one step down from Jack Daniels, but, like, it is luxurious to me right now. Like, this doesn't taste awful. I'm having a Jim Beam and Coke Zero. And I'm not grimacing when I sip it. Oh my god, it actually tastes like proper whiskey. It doesn't taste like I'm drinking brown rubbing alcohol. Holy shit. I'm fancy tonight. I hate... that Jim Beam is me being fancy tonight, but it's the fanciest I can do right now. Being poor is a bitch. And Allie, you do need to play this. Is the only Metroid game you've played Super? I only question your choice of Coke Zero. I can't drink regular soda anymore. I can't. One of the things I started doing was cutting sugary drinks out. Because it's just empty calories. It's empty sugar, it's empty calories. So I started cutting out sugary drinks. And now I can't drink regular. I can't drink regular Coke. Like, I can't drink regular soda. It leaves, like, a weird, like, syrupy film in my mouth. I can't do it. Like, I can't drink sugary sodas. I like the Cherry Coke Zero. The Cherry Coke Zero is really good. like any, like regular, sugary soda, I can't do it now. It makes my mouth just feel sticky and gross. And it gets me all like, eh. I have to drink zero sugar sodas. Love the vanilla Coke and cherry one. Vanilla Coke's good. I haven't really been able to find vanilla Coke Zero very often. I do like the ones that they come out with, like the gimmicky ones they've been doing. What do they think? Like the star, what is it? The gimmicky Coke Zeros they've been coming out with that are like berry flavored or weird shit like that. Dream World, yeah, there's a Dream World one that was like a Stardust one that was like raspberry flavored. It was like Raspberry Coke Zero. Super good. Oh, they're really good. They're really super good. I was skeptical at first, but they're tasty. Very tasty. The Cherry Coke Zero to me. What's up, Aaron? The Cherry Coke Zero to me tastes like movie theater Cherry Coke, which is why I like it. I like the Cherry Coke Zero because it tastes like movie theater Cherry Coke. And that's my jam. I can't go to a movie theater and get anything other than Cherry Coke. Like, that is what you get. You get a Cherry Coke at the movie theater. Movie popcorn. I'm not the biggest popcorn person. I get a movie theater hot dog because they have like those Hebrew Nationals at the movie theaters, or the Nathans, depending on the theater you're at. They have like the Hebrew Nationals or the Nathans that are fucking amazing. I love me a movie theater hot dog. But I don't remember the last time I went to a movie theater. It's too much of a I got spoiled during the pandemic when they were doing releases to streaming services, when they were doing like premium streaming releases. Like, that was how me and my brother saw, like, Black Widow and shit, was they did the, simultaneous, and they had another, Avengers one. They had another Avengers one that was straight to streaming during the pandemic. And, like, seeing new movies on streaming at home on our big screen TV, because we all pretty much have home theaters at this point. We all have big old flat screen TVs, and they sound amazing. And it's like we were able to sit there, and if one of us wanted to go grab a snack or go to the bathroom, we could pause it so nobody missed anything. We didn't have to deal with, like, screaming children and shit, or, like, people sitting behind us talking the whole damn movie. Like, at this point, I can't stand movie theaters anymore. Me and my brother just wait for shit to come to streaming now. Like, any MCU Avengers shit? Because I've got my big screen in here that I play games for stream on. This TV is fucking ginormous that I play my stream games on. And we've got a bigger TV out in the living room if we want to use it. And we just wait for shit to hit streaming. We keep ourselves spoiler-free as best we can. Like, that's how we watched the Super Mario movie. That was how we watched Quantumania. That was how we watched, I think the last movie we watched in the theater was, maybe Multiverse of Madness. I think that's how long it's been since my brother and I have actually gone to a movie theater. We just can't stand it now. It's like, nah, let's just wait for it to hit streaming. We can just sit here and be comfy, cozy. We have our own snacks and our own drinks. No annoying people. No tall motherfucker's gonna sit in front of us and block our view. Honestly, never been big on theaters. Wife was all about that life and dragged me along. I used to enjoy it until I realized how much better it could be. Until the pandemic showed me how much better it could be. I love going to the movies, but it's rare when I go. It's fun when you go with a group of people, but like if it's something that like just me and my brother are watching, we would much rather just watch it at home. Just fire it up on the big screen and just fucking have a time. Because then also we can have our own little comments with each other. Because, like, I don't like talking to people I'm with when I'm at the theater, because I feel rude. But, like, if it's just me and Matt sitting here watching something on a streaming thing, we can sit here and, like, have our little banter about it. That's what we do. We sit here and go back and forth about what we're fucking watching. And that's something, like, I feel rude if I were to do that in a theater, obviously. And I don't want to sit there and be whispering the whole time, because that still bugs people. I hate when people do that in the theater. got Sony surround system years ago, best investment. I want to, because I know I won't use them. I have my big speakers for my karaoke system. For like my PA, my karaoke PA. I have a couple of big fucking powered speakers just sitting in my closet that are just gathering dust because I'm not doing the karaoke work anymore. So I've got these powered speakers. I kind of want to find a way. The DJ Pikachu / DJ Mimikyu booth is a little bit in the way for this. I would love to find a way, though, to get these speakers hooked up to my entertainment center. Holy shit, would that be obnoxious. Where's Squish? It's Squish! It's Squish, the baby Metroid. Allie knows about the baby Metroid because Allie played Super Metroid. So Allie remembers, in Super Metroid at the very beginning, during the flashback sequences where it shows how in Metroid 2, Samus found the baby Metroid. Oh, I have a mixer. I have a mixer. I'm a karaoke DJ. I have a mixer. I have all the equipment I need. I have all the equipment I need. I have my big fucking ProFX mixer. That's what I use for the karaoke on stream, is my ProFX mixer. This is Squish the Metroid. So, Allie doesn't know this, so I'm going to give this to Allie. When we played Metroid 2, so when Metroid Dread was coming out in October of 2021, I didn't know yet when I started streaming in March of 2021. My second game I ever streamed was Metroid Zero Mission, which is a remake of Metroid 1, like the NES Metroid. Metroid Zero Mission, that's the one I recommend you to play if you want to play like the original Metroid, is play Zero Mission. That's like the definitive canon version. And that was the second game I ever streamed. And then eventually I played Metroid Prime, and then we found out Dread was coming out that October. So I flipped the channel into Metroid mode, and we ran through the series in timeline order. So then we played the Metroid 2 remake, the AM2R remake. And at the end of that, in the scene that you've seen, Allie, at the beginning of Super Metroid, where Samus finds the baby, my mod Bella decided that the baby Metroid's name was Squish. We found the baby Metroid at the end of the game, and Bella was like, I'm naming it Squish. Its name is Squish. It is Squish the Metroid. Because it, like, does little, like, squishy movements. She's like, it's Squish the Metroid. And then I warned her. I warned her not to get attached to Squish. Because right after that, we played Super Metroid. And then she saw what happened to Squish at the end of Super Metroid. But I found this plushie online, and I was like, Squish can live on. This can be our Squish. This can be our baby Metroid. I bought one for me, and I bought one because Amy was in her Metroid era at that time, too. Amy Sumisu, she was big in her Metroid era. So I got myself one, and I got her one, because she had mentioned wanting a Metroid plushie. And I found these on, like, Etsy or something. And I was like, fuck it, I'm gonna get myself one, and I'm gonna grab Amy one. Because Amy's my friend, and she's big in her Metroid era right now. So fuck it. Yeah! The fat baby? I got that for her. That was for me. Because I was so happy that she was, like, super into her Metroid era. Like, wearing the fucking Zero Suit cosplays and all that shit. Like, she was...
Oh, no!
That's Amy. She got balls deep into Metroid, and I loved it, because it's one of my favorite video game series. I was like, fuck yeah! And she was like, oh, I wish I could find a Metroid plushie, and I was like, bet, I'm gonna scour the internet right now. And I found that, and I was like, I'm getting her one, and I'm getting me one, fuck it. Like, I want one. And that'll be Squish. That'll be our real-life Squish. I told her, I was like, asking you shall receive. I was like, that is the coolest thing I ever found. I didn't know anybody made a Metroid plushie. I would say, Allie, be careful of spoilers, but I mean, honestly, it's a Metroid game. When you play Fusion, the only real spoiler that you're gonna get from this is what you're going to find out at the very beginning of the game. I'm in a space station that bad shit is happening in. You find that out within the first 5 minutes of the game. So you're really, you might just see me fight a boss. I'm on my way to a boss. But yeah, the only spoiler here is, it's a Metroid game. We're alone in a bad place, and there's aliens that want to eat our face off. Welcome to the series. Like, that's the spoiler, and it's every Metroid game. Hello? Hello? I pissed it off somehow. Where are you wanting me to go? I forget where Adam wants me to go. There's a green door. I think all the hatches are shut right now, though. I hide from spoils just to be careful so I can be surprised by bosses and whatnot. Okay, yeah, go ahead and hide yourself, because, yeah, I would love to watch you go through this fresh. I would say, though, you've played Super Metroid. I would say your next one should be Metroid Zero Mission for Game Boy Advance. That's a good, like, starter after Super. And honestly, if you can emulate 3DS, I would say then do Samus Returns. But to be perfectly honest, for Metroid 2, so Metroid 2 was on Game Boy, but you shouldn't play Metroid 2 for Game Boy. You should play one of the remakes, because they're way more user-friendly, and they're way more definitive. One of them is a fan remake for PC called AM2R, another Metroid 2 remake, which I think is better than the remake Nintendo made for 3DS. But the one for 3DS is the canon one. That is the current canon. So I would say if you can get Citra Knightley to emulate 3DS, I would say Samus Returns would be your best bet, so you can get the canon experience. And then jump into Fusion here. And then eventually you gotta play Dread. I need to watch you play Metroid Dread. Because Metroid Dread is as close to a horror game as Metroid gets. I recently did Metroid Dread at the end of September. That's what started me on this Metroid kick. I randomly did a Dread run at the end of September. And, I still scream and shit my pants when I get to certain parts of Dread because they get so frantic. I want to watch you play Dread. Because I have a feeling you would have a ball with how frantic and terrifying things get. Like, I think you would just be in hog heaven. You would scream in terror and, like, be, like, super, oh my god, what the fuck is happening? But I think you would enjoy the hell out of it. I think you would be like, I'm terrified, but this is entertaining as hell. And yeah, Prime 2. I think you should try Prime. Get the Switch remake of Prime. It's gorgeous. I streamed earlier this year. I streamed the Switch remake of Prime, and like the original GameCube version of Prime still looks good to this day. Like I played it in 2021, and there are clips of me simping over how well the game still looks now. For a GameCube game, the Switch version is beautiful. It is gorgeous. It is so amazing looking. The way they remastered the world is fucking amazing. Samus looks fantastic. The arm blaster looks fucking mwah, chef's kiss. Definitely do Prime. Prime takes place after 1. Prime takes place between 1 and 2. Chronologically, if that influences your play order at all. It goes 1, the Prime Trilogy, then 2, Super, Other M, Fusion, and then Dread is the canon timeline. way later, but this is terrifying, but I'm enjoying it, Mike, through all of Dead Space. All of Dead Space and all of Prey, to be honest. I still love you for giving me Prey. Prey was fantastic. I was screaming, crying, shitting my pants. But is this where I want to... No, this can't be... Wow, I'm blanking. As I mentioned yesterday, Fusion is the one that I've played the least. Like, I play Fusion the least often. I play Super the most often. I replay Super at least twice a year. Like, I don't do it on stream. You've only seen me stream Super twice. But I legit, I replay Super twice a year. I replay Super Metroid twice a year, easy. Fusion. That's a hell of an advert tag. The most fun I've had while shitting my pants. Legit. True facts. True facts. Dead Space and Prey. I still love... I have one featured clip so far. I need to go through and find more featured clips. But I have one featured clip on the channel so far. And it's the culmination of my inevitable emotional breakdown playing Dead Space. Aaron knows exactly what clip I'm describing. The Snake Eater clip. The Dead Space Snake Eater clip. Is my only featured clip so far. I need to go find more. But as soon as I saw that featured clips were a thing, I was like, oh, I know what the first featured clip is gonna be. That sucks. This is the space jump boss! Oh no, this is the... Oh no! Oh no. I know what I... Oh... I think it dawned on me last night when we got here. Remember how I said... Oh... After I actually intelligently did that one SAX encounter. Absolutely beautiful moment. That broke me. That section of the game destroyed me. Remember, remember when I said, yesterday... Aaron hit me with a "you're watching a master at work" when this happened. The one SAX encounter, that I actually did intelligently and was able to navigate without getting chased, which is something I usually fail at, on that particular one. And I said, that's a skippable, SAX chase. If you do it wrong, you're gonna have a chase, but if you do it right, like I actually did, you get to avoid that. The unskippable chase is imminent. It's going to be after I defeat the boss that I'm coming up on. Hello! Oh, it's just one. So Sir, you have no idea how much I will cheese you and not feel bad. Shit! That's what sucks. Oh wait, no, I forgot, I have a thing. I have this thing! Yeah. After I beat the boss that I'm coming up on, boss-ish, kind of boss, the sort of boss that I'm coming up on, is going to be the unskippable, SAX chase. I'm in trouble. Like, legit, I'm in trouble. It's the actual really hard, unskippable SAX chase. Not long after this sequence. And I might die! Oh, not this boss! Oh, no! Oh, no! Oh, God, not this boss! I forgot about this guy! The stupid thing that I thought I was coming up on is not long after this guy. Ah! Shit! You! Oh, I hate this! This is the part of the fight I hate. Not the first phase, but this annoying shit. God! No! Eat my missile! Eat my missile, bitch! RMD1 was in a mood when they designed this.
A master at work.
Don't count your Metroids before they're hatched. This can still go tits up. It ain't over until it's over. Okay. It ain't over till I have the space jump. Fuck a duck. Why would you do it? Okay. Save rooms and recharge rooms are now back online, but with only auxiliary power, no elevators or hatches will work. Without the main silo online, we're still stuck. I believe the source of the problem is the vegetation you saw earlier choking the reactor core components. Is your objective clear? Yeah. We'll have to find the source of those roots to proceed. Yes, Adam, but first... Let me take a selfie. Oh, I missed that in Super Metroid. We're backtracking. Because I've... Oh, no, we can't! Because that's a crumble block. I have to go back around through... I have to go back around to there the long way. That one shaft where I said that I needed space jump to get into a fucking crawl space. We have to go back around the long way. Oh no, it let us right back in here. Sorry, we're in it. Oh god! Some energy back. More passion. More passion. More energy. I hate this section. Not get. Oh no, it's that. Oh, it's that. It's that red door. It's that red door. It's that red door. No, just avoid the stupid bug alien. Really? Oh god, oh god, oh god, oh no, oh fuck. No, 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 oh god! We may have a death. Fucking ready. No! Oh!
You are watching.
Oh god, that startled me. Oh god, I hate that one. It's so fast. It's unavoidable and so fast. She is just on your ass from second one. No, don't you fucking dare. Please kill it. Hatches don't work. Fuck me. Cleaning the garage, and my wife found an old garbage can filled with cigarettes, Tim Hortons cups, and Axe body spray, which was like my dad's. Oh, your dad's signature scent? God. I wore Axe when I was younger. I got older and got way more into like Old Spice and like actual cologne. No. This section is a fucking nightmare. Oh, that's much better. I'm dropping a save state right now. Okay, at least I have a fighting chance. We all matured out of Axe. My dad aged right into it. In my overnight bag, I do keep a little tiny can just for emergencies. Like, if I end up out somewhere and I'm not going to be home and I need to at least, you know, freshen myself up the next day, I have a little bitty can of the, what's the scent? The Dark Temptation. The one that kind of smells like chocolate. I keep that. I keep a little tiny, little bitty mini can in my overnight bag. For like emergency use. Oh God. Oh no! No! Oh my God! I biffed that! Oh my... Oh, I'm gonna get pissed. I don't care. I'm gonna save scum it. I keep fucking it up.
Stop! Oh! I'm about to get my plasma beam if I don't die! God damn it! Jesus Christ, monkey balls!
GG!
Thank you! Oh my god, that was rough!
Whew! You are watching a master at work.
But I got my plasma beam! I've got my plasma beam! Oh, that one is... That's what I was saying earlier. How stupid that one is. Because it's not really a boss fight, but it's just a dumb thing. It's just a room. It's just a fucking bullet hell room. But yeah, do you see how I'm Swiss cheesing these guys now? Compared to earlier? Like, they gave you this room right here to show you, yeah, plasma beam ain't nothing to fuck with. Like, they did that on purpose. They put that room there specifically so you could see, yeah, I'm that bitch now. Motherfucker! I felt like there was a reason for this room to exist, but I guess not! Nah, just if I want to fucking... grind health out of those enemies. No real point in that, though. No, wait a minute!
Hey, yo!
Grind health out of me. What's the matter? Now you don't want the smoke? What's the matter, you, huh? You don't want the fucking smoke? You motherfucker, you! It's bullshit. That's a rough sequence. That's a rough sequence in this game. Like that, the auxiliary power sequence. The auxiliary power sequence is fucking rough. Bitch! Oh, God. Oh! like spreading a gnat's ass over a rain barrel, the precision you have to hit. I can't believe I did that first try. I can't believe it. I always fuck that up. I cannot believe I pulled that stupid ass move off first try. I don't feel like I deserve it. I feel like I made it too easy. I always fuck up the placement on those two rippers. Like, I can never get those two rippers placed quite right. Like spreading a gnat's ass over a rain barrel? That's a dadism. That's a dadism. That's a vertism. That was one of my dad's old, Midwest Indiana sayings. Cause that'd be really difficult, wouldn't it? Spreading a gnat's ass over a rain barrel? That'd be really fucking hard. You ever been so hungry you could eat the ass end out of a goat? That's another dadism. My dad was full of those fucking things. Yes, it would be. You ever know how something like fits? Oh, like a sock over a chicken's lip? When something fits just perfect, it's like a sock over a chicken's lip. That's another dadism. Tighter than a boar's ass in fly season? I like that. My dad would say, hotter than a four-peckered goat in a forest fire. On the 4th of July. What? You've restored plasma beam functionality. Most unexpected. Even so, continue to avoid the SAX. It too may be stronger. And you still lack a few abilities crucial to survival. Wait a second. More trouble. Hold on. I've isolated the cause. There's been an explosion in the ARC data room. Samus, go to Sector 5. Is your objective clear? Yeah. The damage is staggering. Find out what's causing it. I think this is the nightmare section. I think this is the nightmare segment. You heard that one before? Hotter than a four-peckered goat in a forest fire? I like that one. Oh, wait a minute. No. Come on. We have a green door up here we can finally go through now that the hatches are functioning again. And we have power bombs. I like how it's playing like the creepy suspense music, but I'm absolutely not going where they want me to go to resolve that. Hello. Yeah. Oh, fuck it. Oh! Excusez-moi. Second. Anyway. Here we go. All right, let's go to Ark. Fuck it. It's gotten worse. The damage seems to have been caused by a creature kept here by the researchers who named it the Nightmare. Yes, it's the Nightmare segment. Apparently, it was a biomechanical organism designed for military applications. It possesses uncommon power and can manipulate gravity. Gravity suit. We must assume that it's become an ex-host. We have no choice. You must find it and defeat it. I can't confirm the location. Is your objective clear? I mean, kind of! This thing is out of control. Hurry before it destroys the entire station. This... So you know how in that chase a little bit ago, the SAX killed me once? Shame on me. The Nightmare's gonna kill me several times. Okay, I wanna check something. Because it's F1... to load slot one. Is it shift F1? Wait. Okay, so if I stand here, and I go shift F1, and then I go to the other side of the room, and I hit F1, okay, it's the same as the SNES 9X, okay. That's been bugging the hell out of me. It's the same as the SNES emulator. The only thing I ever stuck out is my yacht. How? Oh. That's how. Okay. Bet. Fucking bet. Okay, now we're good. Now we're Gucci. Yeah, see, power bombs before, Samus Returns and Dread introduced the pulse radar. Power bombs are how you used to do that shit. Power bombs were how you cheesed that. Because technically in Super Metroid, You can get the X-ray visor before you get the power bombs, but even if you get the power bombs first, as intended, the X-ray visor is not long after. So in Super, it wasn't really a big issue. You get them both about the same time. But in Fusion, it's absolutely power bombs. Power bombs are your fucking X-ray visor. Wait. Yeah, there's an explosion in the data room. Oh, fuck off. This is speed booster, right? Yeah. That's my way out after I get the goddamn gravity suit. Fuck! That's what I thought I saw! Why make us whole? We are whole. Jules notification message for Dead Space remake. Remake us whole. Oh God! First of all, it's perfect, and I love Drew for doing it. But second of all, how dare he? How dare he do that? How dare? I love Drew, but how fucking dare? No, you motherfucker! Whoa, wait. Oh, that's a busted door. But it tells me I can go through it. I guess not. Sup? I knew there was a fucking gimmick to this one. Because we're gonna want as much energy as we can fucking get for this? This is gonna suck. This is going to suck. Shit, wrong. Shit! Shit! Yeah, they call it a nightmare because this fucking fight is a nightmare. Watch its face! Watch its face as I damage it. This fight is actually legit nightmare fuel. God damn! Fuck! It's just so... It's so hard to avoid! You can't fucking control it, the fight at all! Time to play PC and pops up a window update, of course. I hate this fight. This fight is the bane of... This fight is the bane of my existence. This fight gets me the closest this game gets me to rage quitting. Uppies. This is the fight that informs you that your charged beam is now the most powerful weapon you have. God. Fuck me, dude. Oh, I hate this fight. What is up, Ariel? Yes, I remember your friend who said that dumb shit. Oh my god, I hate this. Jason and I are at his pizza joint that has a 14-inch pizza. Nice! I'm getting ready to rage quit in Metroid Fusion. Fuck! shit. Fuck! Oh, thank you, sweet baby Jesus. Yes, I saved Scum to the last couple hits. I don't give a fuck. I loved Evil Within. It's really fun, especially the cum monster. Evil Within is currently on Epic, so now I have it. I will not be informing him. Oh, God. Yeah, no, I didn't save Scum at all. I didn't save Scum a damn thing. Really? By the way, I'll give you a cum monster. Wait a minute. I would like to redo that. I would like a mulligan on that, please. Where is this pizza place, Ariel? Is this anywhere I would know? Somewhere in P-Dizzle or Landcracker. Wait a minute, what's down further? Ow! I do believe that's the way I'm supposed to go. Yeah, because I need to unlock level 4 security hatches. Ow! Yup, and that's the end of that. So now I gotta go the way that they want me to go. And I don't know if anybody saw me say it in the Discord, but if karaoke gets triggered, I'm gonna sing like a Halloweeny type deal. If anybody's into that sort of thing. That's...
I'm thirsty. Refreshing.
I'm gonna have to refill that soon. Oh, Aaron, I'm chug-a-lug. Chug-a-lug! I actually have Jim Beam tonight. sounds not so obnoxious, but I am the chaos, so. When were you obnoxious? What the fuck? I always forget. I have unlocked level 4 security hatches. You're obnoxious in the Discord? Oh, thank you! Let's get some peeps in this bitch. And let's make me sing some karaoke because I kind of miss it. I haven't sang in several weeks. Damn right. Oh god. He hates him. Oh, fuck it. food porn? ...14-inch slice of pizza. Nice! Where, what is that place called? I might need to check it out. While you tell me, I'm gonna put on the clip screen and I'm gonna refill my drink and I'll be right back. So Mamathy redeemed, who's that Pokemon? So this is Hestia the Flareon. She actually came back with me with DJ Pikachu, from the Philippines. I found her at a big giant mall in Manila. I was looking at all, like, the anime and gaming merch shops that they had over there, and, It was a store on like the third floor, and they had a bunch of big Pokemon plushies this size. And I grabbed her for myself, and I grabbed my brother matching Vaporeon because Vaporeon is his favorite Eeveelution. So, Hestia the Flareon. Technically a Philippine American immigrant. She came from 7,000 miles away to say hi to you. That wasn't the last one. I thought that was the last one. Swallowed me, and I set off a fucking power bomb inside of it. And it exploded.
You are watching a master at work.
Anyway, I have returned. Yeah. Right, I need diffusion missiles for that. I need to get my fucking diffusion missiles. Excuse me? Baking powder? I hate it. No! Oh. My. God. Why? I don't get it. I don't understand. Hey, it's Britt. I was gonna say, what am I, chopped liver? Everybody look to the left. Everybody look to the right. How are you, Britt? How has your week been? Oh, Adam's gonna be pissed at me. You upgraded your missiles. That's unusual. There was no word from HQ. A procedural error, I'm sure. Even so, I did not approve of bypassing security level 4. From now on, you will use more discretion. Fuck you! In any case, Samus, do you remember the security robot you faced earlier? I believe the X have infected it. That is to say, they have claimed the organic components that form its neural network. It has entered Sector 6. I don't know what it's planning, but let's not wait to find out. Samus, you know what to do. We're actually getting close to the end of the game. Like, we're imminently about to beat the game, actually. Weeks sucked, but my last 2 days were good. I'm glad your last 2 days are good. My mouth is doing okay. I still a little tender. My gums are still a little tender, just getting used to the new, you know, the new fit of everything. We have another problem. Once you're done, leave Nock immediately. The SAX is tracking you. Is your objective clear? Yes. Don't stay longer than you must. Understood. But we come to find out that that's not why Adam wants me to leave Nock as soon as I take out the robot. We come to find out that that is not why Adam wants me to get the fuck out of there when I'm done. We're gonna find the thing that Adam doesn't want me to find. If anybody's not sure what it is that I had to do with the dentist on Tuesday, look up Reline. R-E-L-I-N-E. Reline. I had to get a Reline done. Yeah, I can get that once I get my fucking wave beam. I'm gonna get my wave beam momentarily. Okay, Windows Security, don't do that because that made me think that fucking OBS crashed. Friday, though, we all get to hang out together. That's what's important. Also, that I actually went and reshaped, like, actually, like, reshaped my beard properly because I got sick of looking like a hobo who had no access to a mirror. I had way too much beard. You guys didn't tell me that for a while there, I had way too much beard. No, it was my depression beard. It was my depression beard. Absolutely depression beard. I looked like a hobo who didn't have access to a mirror for a while. And then I decided today, when I went in to just kind of do the top and my neck, I was like, fuck it. I'm going to actually reshape my shit. feel presentable again. I had too much beard. It was entirely too much beard. Beautiful, thank you. I appreciate that. I'm gonna go Sunday. I'm gonna go in there Sunday with the clippers and actually, like, trim the length back down. Sundays are usually when I do that kind of shit.
Warning. No entry without authorization. Warning. No entry without authorization. Warning. No entry without authorization.
Warning.
Warning.
No entry without authorization. I hate that even when you leave the area, she still fucking continues to say that. Alright, now the fucking robot wants to play. Motherfuck. Shut up. I understand, I'm gone. I left. I left. Pushy bitch.
No entry without authorization.
Saving state. No, you have to trigger that. You have to trigger that to make this boss fight spawn. We're giving Squish a hug again. Everybody wants Squish to have hugs. We're hugging Squish. We love Squish. We're about to find a bunch of squishes. Put Squish right here. I hate this. Goddamn thing. Oh my! Really, of all fights, this is the one.
Warning.
didn't have it quite at the right spot. Come on, you were being so predictable a little bit ago. Slow and steady, honestly, wins the race on this fight. I forgot at first. Damn it! Get what little hits I can get in. Come on, motherfucker. There we go. Wave beam, baby! Three out of four ain't bad. Good shot, robot. Ugh.
Warning. No entry without authorization.
So yeah, wave beam shoots through walls. For anybody that doesn't remember every other Metroid game we've ever played. Other than the Prime series. It doesn't do that in the Prime series. I'm doing a save state. We're actually gonna beat the game, like, right now. We're, like, imminently about to beat the game. BRB, just leaving. We'll come back when I'm on the... On the freeway? No entry without authorization. Are you not in the AV right now?
Warning. No entry.
Are you and Jace outside of the AV?
No entry.
Excuse me.
No entry without authorization. No entry without authorization.
Restricted zone.
Warning, no entry without authorization.
We're in the restricted zone.
Warning, no entry
Wait a minute. I have to know. Restricted laboratory, but look! It's a bunch of squishes. Look at all these squishes. It's a whole bunch of squish. It's a bunch of baby Metroids. And then a bunch of their different forms. We have a Metroid larva, then we have an alpha Metroid, then we have a gamma Metroid, then we have a zeta Metroid. The Galactic Federation is breeding Metroids. She's heading home from the pizzeria that she and Jace were just at. Well, the SAX. The SAX is way more concerned with these Metroids than it is me. The restricted laboratory is now jettisoned into space and destroyed. And the SAX presumably with it. Samus, you shouldn't have done that. You ignored your orders. You may have to pay a price for that quite soon. As you can see, the Federation has been secretly working on a Metroid breeding program. For peaceful application only, of course, please understand. But perhaps you already knew of this program's existence. Certainly, you must have had doubts when you saw Sector 1. SRX, a faithful replica of the SR388 ecosystem. Ideal for raising Alpha, Gamma, Zeta, and even Omega Metroids. This research even uncovered techniques for rapid growth. Imagine creating an Omega from a larval Metroid in days. But that research is finished. The X has smelled out its natural enemy, and one of the SAX is on its way here.
One? Are you saying there's more than one SAX?
Don't be so surprised, Samus. You know that the X reproduced by asexual division. Because of this mechanism, there are no fewer than 10 SAX aboard the station. Samus, you must go. Get out. If you stay too long, the SAX will destroy you. Stop only at a navigation room to uplink to me. I don't know how HQ is going to take this, but you need to report to them immediately. Is your objective clear? Yes. Now get going.
Well! Isn't that some bibbidi-bobbidi bullshit?
The real Adam would have said the same thing about that incident, but he would have softened the blow. He was relentless in his criticism, but he always cared. He wasn't a machine obsessed with duty. No such compassion could exist in that computer.
I am now back in SRX. Oh no!
Play the game. Give me a second. I know how to play video games. I'm the best at video games. I, as I've told you. a million times before. Oh, fuck off with these things. Really? 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 With these things right now? Don't suck on me. I'm gonna get my screw attack soon. If I recall correctly, we're about to fight Ridley. Duck! Stop it, stop it. There's some fuckers back here that drop red ones. You fuckers! Okay. Let's try this again without the part where I'm a dumbass. No, that's just gonna stay locked. I don't know why that's down here. I need the screw attack to get through there!
I'm
fuck all the way off. Okay, wait. I always fuck up at this part. I can never remember what they want me to do. How do I kill the gold space pirate? Oh, I have to get it from me. Oh, God! I have to get it from behind. I always fuck that part up. That's my way back. That's my way back after I have the screw attack. Come on! I'm sorry. I don't know the point. Do I need to go through here? I just need to dodge the rippers. Shit! It's Ridley, baby! If he bleeds, we can kill him! Right, motherfucker, you die! You're my goddamn screw attack, baby! Here we go! Time we've killed Ridley on this channel. Let's see, we've played Zero Mission once, we've played Samus Returns once, we've played Super Metroid twice, we've played Fusion twice, we've played Prime twice. Out of 8 nickels, which isn't a lot. But it's weird that it's happened 8 times. I have to keep that running gag going. And now I am Sonic the fucking Hedgehog. Hello, I shot the sheriff, but I did not shoot the deputy. But I swear it was in self-defense. I'm dumb. Like, I don't know why you guys are fucking... I don't know why you guys are here. I'm a fucking idiot. Like, what the hell? What the hell are you guys doing here? I'm fucking dumb. Cringe as fuck. Hero. Okay. That's how I open that. Stop it! Get some help. Mother, I will Sonic spin you. I'm a Sonic spin these motherfuckers. You know what bitches get? They get Sonic spinned. Bitches? Bitches? Butters. That was a, That was a Metroid larva shedding. For anybody that caught it. That was a Metroid larva shedding. I forgot that they gave you that bit of foreshadowing on the way back. I forgot that on the way back, they give you that little bit of, foreshadowing. Metroid larvas. I forgot all about that. Because that's to let you know, anybody that's played like 2, that's to tip you off. Oh fuck. There is at least an evolved Metroid here somewhere. There is at least an evolved Metroid somewhere. Samus, we're done here. Leave the rest of the Federation. We should be preparing to evacuate the station.
Are you joking? Do they know how dangerous the X are? How quickly they reproduce?
The Federation has taken an interest in the X and SAX. They believe this life form has endless potential applications.
This is ridiculous! The X are heartless abominations. What potential could they have?
It is not necessary that you understand such matters. The Federation is coming now. You should just leave quietly.
This is madness! They won't stand a chance here! This station will devour them. What could be worth the risk?
Capturing the SAX, of course.
Are you serious? Do they really think they can succeed?
It will certainly be difficult. They don't expect your help. They knew you would try to destroy the SAX. That's why they stopped sending you support data. The plasma beam modification was ready some time ago, but they withheld it to keep you from engaging the SAX. Yet somehow you restored that function on your own. They also tried to withhold the diffusion missile upgrade because they didn't want you to grow too powerful. But they had already sent it, and you tracked it down. Bravo, Samus.
They must cancel this mission. Open a channel to HQ. I won't let this happen.
They are already on their way. Fools.
As soon as the Federation ships land, the X will overwhelm them and absorb the knowledge and power of their occupants. The X are just waiting for the hunt to begin. And then they'll spread across the universe. Galactic civilization will end. The X hunger for form, knowledge, and power, but they mimic these perfectly. But they cannot copy the soul. They're single-minded, instinctively seeking to increase in number. They're a plague, and the Federation underestimates their threat. The X must not leave here. I must destroy them all before the Federation arrives. This station has a self-destruct mechanism. I must use it to destroy the X here and on the planet. I must send them to oblivion. Them, the station, and myself if I have to.
Open the hatch! I have been ordered to confine you until the ships arrive.
Don't let them do this! Can't you see what will happen, Adam?
Adam. Who is Adam?
A friend of mine.
And what would this friend advise you to do now?
He would know that the only way to end this is to start the self-destruct cycle. He'd know how important it is.
Did this Adam care for you? Would he sit in a safe command room and order you to die?
He would understand that some must live and some must die. He knew what it meant. He made that sacrifice once.
And we'll see that when we eventually play Other M someday. Someday when I feel like actually playing Other M. So he chose life for you. Our fair warrior, Samus Aran, your Adam gave his life so that you might keep yours. For the sake of the universe. How foolish.
How dare you? How could you hope to understand, machine?
You know that detonating the station in high orbit would not guarantee the complete extinction of the X-parasites, even though the station would be utterly destroyed. You would only succeed in removing the one obstacle to the galaxy's ruin, yourself. You would ignore this simple fact and choose death. When Adam decided who would live, he chose incorrectly. If you were to alter the station's orbit, then you might be able to include the planet in the vaporization field of the self-destruct detonation. You would have to start the propulsion sequence now, before the Federation arrives. Samus, this is your last mission. Go to the operations room and adjust the station's orbit path to SR388. Then return to your ship and escape. Move quickly and stay alive. That's an order. Any objections, lady?
We're gonna blow the whole place up! I've always said, if they want us to just wreck the place, we have no problem just wrecking the place, baby! We're just gonna wreck the place! Fuck it all up!
Yeah, we're about to beat the game. We're about to fight the penultimate and final boss. Let's make sure we're completely recharged. And then after that, I don't know what to do. If anybody's around that wants to play some party games, I'm down to do that. Or maybe I'll just start fucking playing Zero Mission. I don't care. Creating a save state. God damn! Damn! Fuck a duck, that part is a bitch. Oh wait, I need to fucking... No, let me recharge, but... go back to a recharge room. I don't give a shit. Oh, I'm not allowed. I think I get an auto recharge after this. I think that part's scripted. Orbit change implemented. 3 minutes to impact. It wouldn't be a Metroid game if we didn't have to fucking escape a self-destruct sequence. Now would it? No, it wouldn't. That's the answer. It wouldn't be. Such a pain in the ass! Ship's not here. But a fucking Omega Metroid is. Come on! God, this takes so long. Okay. Here's the SAX! It's gonna fight the fucking Omega Metroid with the Ice Beam. That perfect military mind, the wisdom of Adam Malkovich, continued to serve even after death. Until today, I had no idea that the minds of leaders and scientists were frequently uploaded to computers. My incredible reunion with Adam may have saved the universe. But how will the beings of the universe view our resolve? I doubt they will understand what we did, the danger we barely averted. They will hold tribunals and investigations. They will hold us responsible. Adam understood this, and he spoke to me in my anger. Do not worry. One of them will understand. One of them must. I reflected upon his words, and I see the wisdom in them. We are all bound by our experiences. They are the limits of our consciousness. But in the end, the human soul will ever reach for the truth. This is what Adam taught me. Just one detail still bothers me. This ship can only be started manually. Yet before I faced the Omega Metroid, the ship moved on its own, guided by someone's hands. Is it possible, Adam? No, not Adam. Lady, what's troubling you? You wonder how I started the ship? Just think about it. They lent me a hand. The Decora and the Etikuns. How did I do? Clear time, 3 hours, 29 minutes of play time. That's not bad. Item collection, 56%. And that's Metroid Fusion done. I'm gonna do a DJ Mimikyu break. I'm gonna do a DJ Mimikyu break and then see. What anybody wants to do after. I might just raid out. I don't know. Let me do a DJ Mimikyu break, and then I'll be back.
So, fuck it. Huh. There we go. I guess I'll just play Zero Mission, fuck it. Change the category. Planet Zebus, I called this place home once in peaceful times, long before evil haunted the caverns below. Now I shall finally tell the tale of my first battle here in my so-called Zero Mission. What's up, Ariel? I got my rolly ball. Yes, I know how the rolly ball works. Thank you. What up, Ariel? We really don't have anybody to play any, like, party games or anything like that. And I have no karaoke backlog, so I'm just gonna play some fucking Zero Mission. Fuck it. That's bomb. Ow. Are you, back, are you on the freeway, or where are you, Ariel? And yeah, for anybody that noticed, I did put one goal bar back. I don't really care about subs or bits.
Make us whole again.
Thank you for the resub, Momothy!
Happy Friday.
Happy Friday! Thank you for the resub. 29 months. Holy shit. Long beam. I do believe this is the room, yeah.
That's the way to Turian. Auto captions did its best to spell that, man, and you know what? Oh, God! Excuse me. I do like, over the past month, how I've gone through the series. The order I've done has been, 5, 3, 2, 4, 1. How are you doing, Momothy? How has your week been? Happy Friday. By the way, one more sub and I'll sing a karaoke song. Just pointing that out. Bombs, baby. Ow. I got the early kill on that. If you don't kill that one quick enough the first time, it comes up later when you have more missiles and shit. And sticks around until you either die or beat it. I'm usually not fast enough to kill it on the first appearance. So that's nice. me a second. Yeah. Because I missed that square of the map. Obviously, I'm not going to skip a section of the map. This is me we're talking about. We have to fill the fucking map up. That's bombs. There's that missile tank. Energy tank, baby. Oh. Refill my missiles. Yeah, that room is laggy as hell, and there's a reason for it. Yeah, I know how to use bombs. F is for fire that burns down the whole town, used for uranium bombs! N is for no survivors! Such a pain in the ass. Fuck! Fuck! Funky butt loving! Right, I don't have the ledge grab yet. Oh, you want me to go to Norfair? We're not gonna go to Norfair yet. Not quite yet. We got a little bit of backtracking to do. Motherfucker! Wait, I have to kill these. Haha! Sharad, you are. Fuck! There we go. Usually takes me longer to nail that fucking missile upgrade. Slightly impressed with myself, honestly. I need Ice Beam to get up there. Oh, that's a crumble block. No. The point of that is, hey, Brett. How is the game? Mind, I guess we're going to Norfair. 2-2 top of the 6 Phillies have the bases loaded, and 0 out. Nice! Ooh, actually, give me a second. BRB screen real quick.
How did you survive?
I didn't have a choice. I had to live. I wanted to come home to you. So, I sang your song. Our song. Whew. That was a good game. That was a good video game. And then I got a boop. And then I boop through there. And then that'll give me enough runway. Yeah. I am Lord. Boom! Boom! Woo! Hey, Cutie's raiding us! I didn't say that, did I? Did I say that at 500 followers I would wear my hair in a red mullet? I've gotta delete that clip! I have to delete that clip! Holy shit! I have to delete that clip! I have to delete it very fast! Oh, shit! Ooh. Okay. I had to run to the restroom real quick. I had to reapply on the bottom. My gums were... It worked itself loose. And at the moment, while my gums are still tender and getting used to the new fit, it doesn't take much for them to really start hurting me. That's much better. Oh. Got some cushion back. Dodgers fan, we're rooting for the Phillies. I went to a Dodgers game once when I was a kid. I'm from LA. So I went to a Dodgers game once when I was a kid. It was kind of fun. I had a Dodger dog. Never really been a big sports ball guy, though. You can tell. You know, the main sport that I'm into is chocobo racing. Wrong, but I did not mean to click what I just clicked. Oh my god. No. You are gonna take up way too much CPU. There you go. Okay. A lot of people prefer going in person than watching on TV. It's a different experience. I had one... when I was working for Microsoft, Management had like an incentive thing for like really good agents or whatever, management people, whatever, that they kind of selected. And at one point, I ended up going to a Lakers and Clippers game. We were in like a VIP box. This was at least 10 years ago. Down at the Staples Center, that was pretty fun. No. No, I'm gonna get this missile early. They want me to have high jump for that missile. Fuck that shit. Who needs the high jump? Unknown item, yeah, once I get my full suit upgrade, that's going to become the plasma beam. That gorilla grip, baby. Really isn't a whole lot we can do out here yet. Oh, motherfucker! That's a power bomb door right there. Oh god! Can't get enough purchase on that wall to do a wall jump up. I always forget where I can and can't fucking sequence break this game. For some reason, I thought there was a bombable part of that. Oh, God! Anyway. God! GBA emulator. I own the cartridge somewhere. It's in a box somewhere. But no, this is on a... This is just on a Jeep. This is on a Visual Boy. Right, I need the ice beam for that shit. Cause I don't think there's a way to... Yeah, there's no way to get to it from this side. That's just to tease you. Hates it. Oh god, I'm gonna die. Ice beam! Yeah. I know how ice beam works. Old school graphics to me just always work for Metroid. Oh, yeah! I love retro shit. It's what I grew up with. Save room? Yeah, save room. I do love the way Dread looks, though, too. Dread looks amazing. It's like the best of both worlds. Oh, wait a minute. Whoa. No! Save room. Got me wanting a Metroid plushie? Hell yeah! I love my little Metroid plushie. But still not quite where I wanted to go. There we go. No! Come on. No! Fuck! I can't freeze it. Fuck off. I'm gonna give this a couple more tries and then I'm just gonna come back with the high jump when I'm supposed to. Does it only work if it's from the other side? That didn't count because I had it incorrect. I had the setup wrong. So close. There it goes. There it. Okay, he's up. All right, he's up here. Oh, did they put that in my way? Yeah. That's right, yeah, they fucked that up so you can't do it. I forgot. I forgot they fucked up that sequence break. That's something you could do in the original game. Because that little sloped wall wasn't there. You could freeze the little fucker to get yourself access to the Varia suit early. I forgot how many things they did in this version to safeguard against sequence breaks. What up, Baron? Oh, that's neat. I like that. Every game has a different bomb jump rhythm. Gotta find it. Each game is different. I think I'm gonna raid out. $7.39 for me. I'm gonna go ahead and raid out. Who do I want to raid? Okay, keyboard. God, I need a new fucking keyboard. Oh, neat. Let's go raid Drew playing Dead Space.
But I hope you leave enough room for my fist, because I'm going to ram it into your stomach and break your goddamn spine!
Make us whole again.
Fuck it. Use this raid message. Grab that one. And we're gonna raid Drew. And yeah, we'll go raid Drew, go playing Dead Space. It looks like the game has given him some fucking bitrate issues, maybe? Let me refresh him. Oh no, that's not on my end. The game is really fucking up his bitrate. But, you know, we'll go see him. Next Wednesday, we're in a little Halloween raid train. It's going to be a super late stream. I'll keep you guys updated. But yeah, have a great night, guys.